from time to time, we can have a successful buyer at an auction not want to actually sign the contract after the auction. It's a difficult situation, isn't it, Brian?
Not a lot of fun.
Not a lot of fun. Now, every situation is different, but what's one tip that you could give to agents handling this, that sort of predicament?
Well, there's more than one we need to give them, really, but the first one is don't let the underbidder go. You know, I see all the time now, because of the way the market's been, that they just take the highest bidder in and start talking to them, and the underbidder wanders away. The underbidder needs to stay. It gives you options if that first bidder is playing any games at all with you, okay? Games, I don't want to pay, haven't got deposit, I want extended settlement. All these things they start asking after the hammer's come down. You need to keep the underbidder there. Second tip is, before you do anything, get written instructions from your owner. They should direct you about what they want you to do. Third tip is, don't give them any legal advice. Certainly, you give them their options, but no legal advice. Fourth tip is, their solicitor should always be able to be contacted an hour before and an hour after auction, because they're the ones that you want to get the advice from of what they want you to do. Don't make your decisions, get advice from them.
Perfect. Thanks, Brian.
Thank you.